माई वॉइस इज ऑडिबल टू ऑल? इफ यस देन प्लीज टाइप वाई इन द चैट बॉक्स. ओके थैंक यू शिल्पा.
यस मैम.
ओके दिस इज योर 109 क्लास. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ कोर्स 109 आई डिड द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द एंटायर पार्ट. इन 109 कोर्स दैट इज द कॉम्पिटेंसी टू टोटल थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ लेसन आर इंक्लूडेड. कैन यू जस्ट टेल मी नेम्स ऑफ द लेसन? Which three types of lessons are included? Please mute yourself, Renuka.
Yeah, ma'am. Actually, I'll unmute for tell you this unit number 3, 1 to 3.
Okay.
Technology based teaching.
Yes.
Is first. Second unit is theme teaching,
yes.
And third one is lesson using mode of teaching.
That is the models of teaching. See.
Yeah.
These are not the units, these are the different types of lesson. We can say the kinds of lesson. So you supposed to conduct total three types of lesson. The first is technology based teaching, the second is team teaching, and third is the models of teaching. Okay, so before going to move ahead, I just wanted to share my screen. Just tell me my screen, is it visible to all? I'm just going to sharing the screen.
Yeah, ma'am, it's visible.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so first we'll see the first kind of lesson, that is technology based teaching. But before that, you should know about the teaching aids. So myself, Pratibha Dabhade, I'm going to teach you about the teaching aids today, and we'll focus more on the technology based teaching, isn't it? Okay, just tell me, as a teacher, we have to use different kinds of teaching aid. Why there is a need of using different kinds of teaching aids in the teaching or while teaching? Tell me your answers. You can see number of participants are very less. Either you can unmute yourself or you can just type your answer in the chat box.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Can I say?
Yes, please.
While using teaching aids, the student can be easily understand the concept or whatever we teach.
Okay.
To the student,
they can
understand easily.
Your good name?
Swati. Swati Lange.
Yes, Swati. Very nice answer. I want some other answers.
Ma'am, this is Veda.
Yes, Veda, please say something.
Ma'am, also to create interest in the students.
To create what? I'm not getting you.
Interest.
Okay.
More interesting.
Okay. For better understanding of the concept, to create more interest among the students. I want some other answer. Please try to interact.
Ma'am, can I interrupt you?
Yes, please.
Like for example, if with the help of teaching aids, means for example with the help of projector, with the flashcards, means small people, means small children, for example, for the age of 3 and 4,
okay,
and 4 and 5, these children are very less in knowledge, means at this very small time, means they wanted to know, but with the help of teaching aids, with the help of chart boards, with the help of flashcard, projectors, means these children can understand each and everything very easily.
Yeah, no, actually the main thing is,
ma'am, this is Veda.
Yes, Veda. Yes, please say something, Veda.
Ma'am, so in a class, the understanding for the students are different. For example, the children, those who are capable of scoring very high marks, their understanding level is different. So understanding level of each and every student is different. So under using different teaching aid will reach the student, will reach the concept of the students with different level of understanding.
Okay, very nice answer. See, if we see, there are different level of students in the classroom, intellectual levels, the middle level and the lower level students. But actually teacher supposed to plan his or her lesson by considering the middle level students as well as by considering the lower level students, isn't it? So the teaching aid, it will help not only the teachers but for the learners also, for getting easily understanding of the topic or the concept. Okay, screen is visible to everyone so that I can move ahead.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, teaching aids are useful to reinforce what we are saying. For example, suppose just I am using the lecture method by using this Zoom meeting. Okay. So instead of showing you PPT, if I use only the lecture method, so automatically it will not reinforce what I am saying here. Okay. So the teaching aids, we can say that reinforce what we are saying. Ensure that your point is understood. Okay. The next is hint what is important and essential. For example, suppose you are teaching any concept of science subject, we are teaching the functioning of the heart. So at that time, with the help of pointer, with the help of cursor, with the help of video, we can show the important parts of the heart. So that by using the teaching aids, we can give hint to the students. That is also important. Enable students to visualize or experience something that is impractical to see or do in real life. Can you give me example of this? I'm going to repeat this. Enable students to visualize or experience something that is impractical to see or do in real life. I want answers from your side. You can unmute yourself and you can say. Yes. No answers.
Ma'am, this is Veda. For example, if we are trying to give some science experiments that we are practicing in the lab.
Okay.
Something like that or.
See. Something that is impractical, we cannot give direct practical to them.
Okay.
It is not possible direct to see that particular things with the naked eyes. So for that, for example, tsunami is there.
For example, ma'am, microorganism.
Yes, very nice. Microorganisms, we cannot see microorganisms
with the help of naked eyes.
Yes. So for that, we can use the
microscope or yes. Different types of methods by showing the microorganisms.
Yes. Otherwise, you can, yes, for different kinds of methods, you can use the presentation, we can use the videos for showing the impractical or the things which cannot see with the naked eyes.
Yes.
Okay. Engage students' other senses in the learning process. Means what? See, basically, which senses students are using while learning in the classroom? Suppose, see, I'm teaching you course 109, isn't it? So at that time, just now, which senses you are using for learning? Just tell me the answer.
Eyes and ears.
Yes, visual, very nice. Yes, visual and auditory. You can say eyes and ears. So if you are using teaching aid, for example, instead of presentation as a teacher, if I'm using chart in the classroom, so to the student, they will look into the chart. So simultaneously, even they look into the towards the blackboard. So simultaneously, they are using both the senses, that is eyes and ears, isn't it? Facilitate different learning style. As you all know, there are different learning styles. Some learners, they are auditory learners. Some learners, they are visual learners. Some learners, they are audio visual learners. So as per the requirement of the learners, we can use different teaching aids to facilitate different learning styles. That's the reason we have to use different teaching aids in the classroom while teaching different subject. Isn't it? Understood the basic thing? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes. Thank you. See, the basic definition of teaching aids. The teaching aids are materials that the classroom teacher uses to help students understand the concepts sure he introduces during his or her lesson. Isn't it? This is the simplest definition of the teaching aid. Any kind of material. Suppose if I want to show the types of plant or the structure of the plant or the parts of plant. So for that, I can directly take a small plant in the classroom. That can be a real object. Even for teaching mathematics subject, we can show different shapes which are available in the classroom. That is also a teaching aid. So whatever material that classroom teacher or the teacher uses in the classroom for the better understanding of any concept of any subject, that is nothing but the teaching aid. Understood this? Should I move ahead?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
See, we learn, we retain. Retain means retention rate. Retention means what? Can anyone tell me? Retention means what? See, most of the time.
The memory.
Yes, that
we are able to remember it.
Yes, yes, we able to remember it or that.
Whenever the
retention.
Whenever this topic comes, we can remember.
Retention means if a child is leaving from the school and we convince the parents to keep the child in the same school, it's known as retention.
No. Retention means what? It is related to the remembering. Okay. So how much we remember? That is nothing but the retention. So if we are using
retention means gaining of knowledge.
It's not only gaining of knowledge. See, suppose now I'm teaching you this particular 109, that is competency 2. But after teaching this, how much knowledge retain in your head? आपके समझ में कितना आया है, आपको आपको कितना समझ आया है और आपके मेमोरी में कितना है बाद में, that is retention. Okay. Suppose after reading, see here the percentage is given. It tells us the retention rate. After reading whatever we read, only 10% remains in our memory. That is nothing but the retention after reading. That is 10% only. When we hear something, the retention rate, that is 20%. When we see something, then the retention rate is 30%. And when we use both the senses, that is hearing and visual sense, that is the retention rate automatically it increases and it is 50%. And if we are using any activity based, if we are using different activities for the learners, and the retention rate it is higher. So we have to select the medium, or we have to select any teaching aid as per the need of the students, and for that we have to also think about the retention rate. See why audio visual aids are necessary. The Edwards and Mercer says, I hear, I forgot, I see, I remember, I do, I understand. So simply we can say these are audio visual aids. It is a medium. See, it is just a medium. It mediates. What it mediates? It mediates learning in the students. See, the next is choice of medium. Choice of medium means what? Suppose I'm going to teach the topic motion. Okay. So for that, just tell me which type of medium you can select for teaching that concept. Concept is motion. Yes? No answers? Okay. Yes. Who is ready to answer? Choice of medium.
Ma'am, medium motion means moving. So anything that is moving. So in a classroom, a fan is moving. You can show that.
Yes.
Yeah, car is moving outside the window. So that is also in motion.
Okay.
So anything which is in motion, a teacher while walking in the classroom and teaching, the teacher is in motion.
Yes, very nice. It means you can give real experiences to the students. But suppose, can you give another example? For example, the
topic. Pendulum of a clock.
Okay, pendulum of a clock. Okay, nice example. See, suppose we'll take example of geography subject. The topic is occupation. So for teaching that particular topic, which medium you will select?
Sorry, ma'am, that is not clear. I don't understand that.
See, those who are from arts background, maybe they are having one method, that is geography method, and the topic, I have selected one topic, the name of the topic, that is occupation. So basically there are three type of types of occupation, primary, secondary, and tertiary occupation. So for teaching that particular topic, which medium or which kind of teaching aid you can use? Just tell me.
Ma'am, can I? Rajkumari here.
Yes, Rajkumari.
Role play, ma'am?
See, here we are talking about the teaching aid. The role play, that is one another method of teaching. Here we are only talking about the teaching aids.
Okay. Flashcards can be used where we can show the different helpers, community helpers. We can use flashcards, ma'am.
Yes. You can use flashcards. You can also use the PowerPoint presentation also.
Yes, ma'am.
Can we use globe photography?
Yes, of course you can use. See,
globe.
Yes, globe. That is also a teaching aid. You can use that kind of teaching aid also.
Okay.
So it's see, but we have to think about the appropriateness of the medium. Not only if it is only just available, don't think about the availability. You have to first think about the appropriateness of the selection of the medium. I will take one example of science subject. Suppose I'm going to teach circulatory system in the classroom and only the chart is available with me. So is it the right medium for the teaching that particular topic, that is circulatory system? Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Yes. So instead of chart, the chart only available with me. But instead of chart, if I will use video of the circulatory system, so that will be good for better understanding of the student. So the main thing is appropriateness of the selection of or choice of medium. Okay. Basically, there are different types of teaching aids. See. As you all know, there are nowadays many teaching aids are available. Initially, just recall the classroom teaching 40-50 years before. So only the blackboard and chalk is there. But nowadays, see the evolution in that. The blackboard is replaced by the green board. The green board is replaced by whiteboard. Whiteboard is replaced by smart board, and nowadays we are using e-board. See, just now I'm using e-board. Okay, so this is the evaluation in the teaching aids, you can say. But basically, we can classify all the teaching aids in three categories: visual aids, auditory aids, and audio visual aids. Now tell me, what do you understand by the words, by listening the words visual aids, audio aids, and audio visual aid? Just tell me one by one. First we'll see about the visual aid.
Visual aids means by seeing.
Okay.
Blackboards.
Like only by smart seeing board. The blackboard, smart boards,
blackboards. Just tell me what is meaning of visual aids.
Visual aids means those teaching aids we can use to see. Visually, okay. We can see that.
Yes, visually we can see that. Very nice. Then audio. Yes, we can see. And then
ma'am,
audio.
Visual aids are the teaching materials which we use
one for. See, your voice.
Audio means which we can listen.
Yes, audio means. Yes, we can hear. We can listen. Just give your answer one by one. Okay, I will getting cracking noise. Okay, then third is audio visual aids. Means in visual aids we are using the sense of vision, in audio aids we are using the sense of hearing, and audio visual aids, here we are supposed to use both the senses, that is vision as well as hearing. We'll see different examples. First you should give me different examples of visual aids. The blackboard is the one aid.
Pictures.
Yes, pictures.
Okay. Maps.
Maps, very nice.
Videos.
See, here we are talking only about the using the sense of vision. If it is video, we are not going to use that video by muting that video. Okay. So here only think about the visual things which we can
flashcards. See. Printing materials.
Charts.
Yes, flashcards.
Flashcards, printing materials.
Painting materials. Give me some more examples of visual aids.
Textbook is also example of visual aids only.
Yes, it is also. See, it is an object we can see.
Yeah.
That also comes under visual aids. See, you can, if you are using any kind of object in the classroom, that is nothing but visual aids. Okay. Can you, anybody tell me the difference between pictures and charts?
Ma'am, in pictures only we can see the images, but in charts there is some information is also there. Yes, with the pictures.
Information is given with the pictures.
Very nice. When the information is given with the pictures, that is nothing but the chart. So both are the visual aids. Okay. Even the pictures, they can be 2D and 3D pictures also. So can you give me difference between, can you tell me difference between 2D and 3D pictures?
Yes, ma'am.
Even... Ma'am. See, or give me, or just tell me the difference between the pictures or models.
Pictures are only two dimensional, and models are three dimensions.
Very nice. The pictures are two dimensions. Just tell me the dimensions. Tell me the dimensions.
Length and breadth for pictures. Length, breadth, and height for models.
Yes, very nice. Okay, so that is the basic difference between the pictures and models. We also see pictures also 3D, but whenever the third dimension is given, you can convert it into the model. That is nothing but the visual aids. Okay, see, the aids which use sense of vision are called visual aids. The various examples are enlisted here: actual objects, models, pictures. You can use any kind of picture. Charts, maps, chalkboard, overhead projector, or you can say slides, etc. Have you heard this projector, about this projector?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Overhead projector. See, again, we can categorize different teaching aids in the two types, that is projectile teaching aid and non-projectile teaching aid. So here, this projector, that is overhead projector, is, it comes under projectile teaching aid, isn't it? So out of these, blackboard and chalks are common aids one. See, these are very common things if you are using blackboard, chalk, green board, whiteboard, etc. Okay, but apart from that, you have to use to select other teaching aids. Then the next is audio aids, the aids that involve the sense of hearing. They are called as audio aids. The examples are radio, tape recorder, gramophones, etc. See, in your teaching, can you use audios? Where you can use these audio aids? Just give me example.
We can teach process of circulation with the help of audio aids.
How you can teach the process of circulation with the help of audio aids?
Yes. What the teacher teach in the classroom, that is audio only.
See, but teacher is saying something. Means the students are listening something. But see, whenever teacher is using any medium, so here we have to think about the any medium teacher selected by the teacher. So these are the examples of medium: radio, tape recorder. So basically, these teaching aids, it will help in the teaching of languages. Suppose you are going to teach any poem. So before going to class, you can recite the poem. You can just record that poem in your own language, and you can just play that tape recorder in the classroom. So students will get idea how to recite the particular poem. Understood?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That is about the audio aids. And the third type is audio visual aids. The aids which involve the sense of vision as well as hearing are called as audiovisual aids. The example, the television, you can say TV or the projector. See, nowadays for projecting presentations, we are using LCDs and DLPs. So these are the projectors. But suppose I'm only using the presentation, if there is no video, no audio, nothing is there, then in which category you can include that presentation, PowerPoint presentation, just tell me. I'm going to repeat. If I'm not using any audio, there is no hyperlink of any video, I'm just adding content on the presentation and displaying the presentation in front of the students, then that presentation in which category you can include? Yes, that is visual. But if I'm adding any video in that, if I give any hyperlink of any video, then you can say that is audio visual aids. Yes, that is audio visual aids. Very nice. Okay. So now I'm going to focus on the technology based teaching. Just tell me fast, which teaching aid you will use in technology based teaching?
Google Forms.
Just think about the classroom teaching.
Smart boards, projector.
Project, you say you can use the projectors, you can use smart boards. Okay. Anything else? In the first type, that is visual aids, I told you about the OHP that comes under. Again, that is a technology. So that OHP that comes under technology based teaching aid. Okay. You can use presentation directly, you can show different images, and even by the zoom option you can zoom different images while teaching particular content. Okay. You can show different audios by using the tape recorder, by using the radio. Okay, that also comes under technology. So in visual we can say OHP you can use, even the plain PowerPoint presentations you can use in the technology based teaching. You can use audios in that, radio, tape recorder you can use. In audio visual you can use the projectiles, means you can use presentation with the audios. This, see, everything comes under technology based teaching. Understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Now I'm going to just display one images. Just tell me, is it comes under technology based teaching? Means can we use this aid for the technology based teaching? Just tell me yes or no. Okay. Mobile phones.
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. It comes under which type of aid?
Audio visual.
Yes, it can be audio, video, or audio visual. It depends on us. Okay. This
visual.
Okay, let me tell you. If directly I'm, please, some voice disturbing voice is there. Okay, thank you. See, if directly I'm using this as a model, then it comes under only visual aids. This is not technology based aid which we can use for the technology based teaching. But if I'm using this as a slide, then you can say slide of presentation, then you can say it comes under technology based teaching aid. This, again, the same thing about this. If I directly use this human skeleton in the class, then it comes under, it is the model. Yes, it is model and it comes under the visual aids. But if I'm using the picture of skeleton on the presentation, that it is technology aid, we can say. Again, this is the same thing about the heart also. Okay. See, digestive system. I'm using this chart. This is the chart. It comes under which aid? Which type?
Visual aid.
Visual. Yes, it comes under visual aids. What is this?
Graph chart.
This is a type
pie chart. It's a pie chart.
Yes, it is a type of chart. That is nothing but pie chart. So we can use this pie chart with the help of presentation. Again, it comes under technical or technology aid. The simple thing, that is PowerPoint presentation. If there is no audio, no video, then simply we can say this comes under visual aid. And it is a part of technology aid.
Technology aid.
Yes. Again, geography students, they can use. See, instead of just pasting this image on the PowerPoint presentation or the slide of PowerPoint presentation, directly I can just show image. Okay, with the help of projector, we can use LCD for or DLP for that. So, if you want to stay focus on the particular state of the India, then we can zoom that image. So it will, the student will get clear idea about the different states in the India. See, this is the picture of OHP, that is overhead projector. See, this is the mirror. And we have to see, have you used this before? That is OHP, overhead projector. So for overhead projector, we have to use different transparencies, and with the help of glass marker, or you can say transparency marker, we have to write the content. Even you can draw the diagrams on the transparencies, and whatever content and diagrams, so we can, we see, we supposed to keep that transparency here. And the reflection that will be displayed in the board. So this OHP, it also comes on, it is also technical aid. Okay. This is tape recorder. It comes under which category? It comes under
audio aids.
Yes, very nice. It comes under audio aids. Shoulder external rotation view. Can you tell me which joint is this? The shoulder joint. Which joint is this? Just recall.
Ball and socket joint.
Very nice. This is ball and socket joints. So, just tell me about this image. I just used. What I use here? X-ray of the shoulder. Okay. See. In the next slide, some names are there. So if you are teaching about the particular joint, you can use different mediums. Okay. So this comes under, if I'm directly I'm showing them this X-ray, then it comes under which aid? Which type of aid? It comes under
visual aid.
Visual aids. But if I'm showing this aid or image of this X-ray with the help of presentation, then it is
technology.
Yes, technology aid. Okay. Okay. I'm going to click on this example. Is it visible to everyone?
No, ma'am. So clearly system is not visible.
I displayed one video on my screen. Is it not visible?
No, ma'am.
Okay, wait. No, ma'am. Okay, wait. We'll stop sharing here. Now it is visible?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This video is about the heart and circulatory system. Okay, now I'm going to stop this video. Just wanted to give you an idea. See, in the presentation, just you can use hyperlinks. Okay. If it is not possible for you to give hyperlink and internet is available, just now I use the same because my hyperlink was not open. So I directly use internet. Okay. So understood about the technology-based teaching or the basic idea about the teaching aids?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
ma'am. Now I'm going to stop screen sharing. Okay. So what you have learned today? Just tell me from the beginning. Yes, what you have learned today?
The definition of teaching aids. There are three types of teaching aids. Visual aids, audio, and third one is audio visual.
Okay, very nice.
And examples of all these three.
Okay, we'll see one by one. So others also, they will just get recapitulation about this. First, we saw about the why there is a need of using teaching aids. Okay, and the answers were for the better understanding of the concept, to stimulate the learning of the students. It helps teachers also for better understanding of the students. Okay, and if we see the retention rate, if the teacher is using different teaching aids, the retention rate is higher. That's the reason teacher is supposed to use various teaching aids in the class, isn't it? So we can say the teaching aid is a medium that mediates. What it mediates is mediates learning of the students. Okay, but teaching aid, it should be, just recall that specific word, it should be the selection or the choice of teaching aid, it should be
the medium of selection.
Yes,
appropriate.
Yes, it should be appropriate. It should not just only available, so it should be appropriate. Then the teaching aids, it's a medium which used by the classroom teacher for better understanding of the concept in his or her class. That is nothing but the teaching aid. Basically, we saw the three types of teaching aid. The types are the visual aids, audio aids, and
audio visual.
Yes, audio visual aids. The visual aids means where we use the sense of vision. Audio aids means where we use the sense of hearing, and audio visual aids where we use both the senses, that is vision as well as hearing. Okay, then next, what we saw, the different examples of audio aids, visual aids and the audio visual aids. Even we saw the difference between the projectile and non-projectile teaching aid. See, projectile teaching aids means what? For the projection of something, we require the machines. That nothing but the the LCD, OHP, DLP, all these are the projectors. So they comes under the projectile teaching aid. So images, we cannot display any image without using this kind of machines. Okay, so that nothing but the projectile teaching aids, isn't it? If you are using TV, that comes under non-projectile teaching aid. Then the next, basically we focuses on the technology based teaching. So in technology based teaching, which type of aids we can use? Just tell me one by one. I think Vikasa is waiting, so we'll wind up this session within 2 to 3 minutes. Yes,
ma'am, can you repeat the question?
See, which teaching aids you can select for technology based teaching? Just tell me different examples one by one.
Overhead projector.
Very nice. That comes under projectile teaching aid. We can say, yes, technology aid. Yes, so give me some more examples.
Radio.
Yes, radio, tape recorder. These
tape
are the
recorder.
Audio aids. Yes, give me some more examples.
Smart boards.
Yes.
And for the visual, blackboards.
See, we are talking about the technical aids or the technology aids. So blackboard, that is not. Yes, we can use presentation. So you can say PPTs. If you are using any audio or video in the PPT, then you can say that is audio visual aids. Otherwise, it can be only visual.
Television.
Yes, very nice. Television, even the mobile phones, we can say that comes under audio visual as per our use. If you're only using any audio clip, then that can be an audio aid. If you're showing any video, that can be an audio visual aid. So these are the different examples of technology based teaching or the aids which we can use for technology based teaching. I think you all understood these topics very well.
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much. In the next lecture, we'll continue the second part of this 109 competency 2. Okay, till then, bye bye. Please take care, stay at home, stay safe. Thank you, bye bye.
Thank you, ma'am.